the mindset of a customer service expert. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to identify the specific characteristics of the best customer service representatives and how you want to implement them in your business. Customer service is more than just a procedure or philosophy to follow. A true customer service expert is excellent at what they do because they have a certain mindset in dealing with customers. If you want your company to offer a service that wows your customers and makes them sing your praises, your staff needs to have this mindset from the moment they're hired. Here are the essentials. Customer complaints are opportunities. Most employees see customer complaints as threats to their company, their competence, their position, or their reputation. But the right mindset sees complaints as the greatest feedback you could hope for. They expose the weaknesses in your business that you wouldn't have otherwise seen. You can learn which areas need improvement, and you learn it from your customer's point of view. Keep in mind also that disgruntled customers who get excellent service from you often turn out to be your biggest fans. There is always a solution. To every problem with a customer, there's a solution. That solution is the customer getting a satisfactory outcome. In order to solve their problem, you have to make it your own problem. Rather than representing the company in an adversarial or defensive position with the customer, work together with them in partnership to reach that goal. Of course, if what they want goes against your company policies or is impossible, you can't get it for them. But you can find other ways to make them satisfied. Always aim for a positive outcome for the customer. Customer service doesn't end at closing time. In the age of international business and the internet, customer service is an ongoing concern, even when you clock out for the day. You need to respond quickly to customer concerns, questions, and comments. This is one of the surest and easiest ways to impress people with excellent service. In order to stay available, create a system whereby customers can access some sort of customer support at all hours. This doesn't always have to be a live person, depending on your nature of business. It could be a knowledge base or contact form. Just make sure your customers know when you'll respond if you can't do so immediately. Stay with them until they're satisfied. Good customer service sees it through to the end. Try to avoid shuffling people off to another department, another person, or online resources like a website. Referring customers to online resources is common practice today, but it's not convenient for the customer. When you do that, you take a big risk. What if their question isn't answered? They're likely to call you back and not be so patient this time. Stay with them, and at the end of the interaction, ask them if they got everything they needed. There's an app for that. Technology offers multiple ways to make tasks easier and more streamlined. Things like apps and automated programs make transactions quicker and easier for your customers. After you've helped a customer, let them know that there's a way they can do it faster on their own. Walk them through the process if necessary. They'll appreciate the ability to get immediate answers when they need them. A customer service expert walks in two pairs of shoes at the same time, their customers and their businesses. Your goal is to reach a solution that makes both parties happy and satisfied. Strive to always create a win-win situation. Activity. Think about your current customer service mindset and that of your team. Do you agree with the guidelines in this lesson? Note anything you would add or change.
Detachment. Everyone likes a bit of concern and a show of interest, and this is why customer service should never appear to be disinterested in a client's likes, dislikes, and even their personal details like profession and family. Always take care to listen to them and never presume to know their mind. And remember, presuming and trying to provide solutions for their so-called problems is the worst mode of action in this field of work. Inhospitality. When customer service is what you do, then the unforgettable code is never let a customer feel uncomfortable. This holds true in the business cases and the people who handle the cases. This is especially crucial because different customers have different criteria for what they deem uncomfortable. So once again, know your customers, the nature and status, and accordingly deal with them. Make them comfortable and then do business. Rudeness. A mere courtesy statement is not what is required from customer service. Clients are more attuned to you and your attitudes towards them than you are aware of. So possessing and holding forth a right, welcoming, easygoing body language is extremely necessary. In fact, a nice, confident greeting along with direct, clear eye contact can go a long way in breaking the ice with clients and winning their trust. Attitude. Just like your day is made up of ups and downs, so is your client's. A previous brawl or an unhappy incident could have soured your client's mood just as it could have yours. So remember to gauge the attitude of your customer and handle them accordingly. An optimistic and helpful attitude on your part will go a long way in making your clients feel better and vice versa. So remember to always uphold a positive image in front of clients to help them feel better. Ignorance. Not knowing what your customer wants is the worst fault in customer service. As mentioned earlier, listen to your customers, their priorities, and accordingly help satisfy them by giving them the best. If you act without knowing, not only will it cause customer dissatisfaction, but also needless hassles. Inaccessibility. An answering machine like looped messages being replayed into customers' ear is probably the most annoying thing that your client can face. So the first job of any effective customer service is to be available when the client needs you. Aiding them is your job, not leaving them hanging. Make sure you give them the right direction and help in solving their dilemmas. Keep your promises. Do what you have promised as soon as possible. Inability to keep your word is one of the greatest sins in the area of customer service. Not only will it take your client's trust away from you and depress them, but it will also deter him or her from dealing with you again. So you should always follow through with deeds, objectives, and quality of service and goods as you have promised to ensure good rapport in the future for their benefit and yours.